Fuck it is, man. Pill Bellamy and this bitch, you heard me. You mad enough. Real quick. Bro, this nigga Sue Surf is a terrible friend, bro. Like, you hearing it here first. This nigga is a terrible friend, bro. Like, and he give horrible advice, bro. This nigga Sue Surf give horrible advice. He told Nunu, you don't have to explain yourself. Like, look at Lori Harvey. Niggas accuse her of fucking every nigga in the world, and we have never seen this girl get on the internet and explain herself. We have never seen her deny sucking 20 dicks in a row. You do the same thing. Deny it. Matter of fact, don't explain yourself. Fuck them niggas. You new, it is what it is. Like, bro. Matter of fact, let's be fair. Let's be fair. Now, to be fair, technically, it ain't none of our business. If she fucked Beasley, she fucked Beasley. If she didn't, then so be it. It really ain't none of our business. We don't live with these people. We ain't never in their personal space. We don't know their relationship. You feel me? We like it really ain't our business. We ain't got to wear it on our jacket. That's her life. That's her pussy. That's his dick. Whatever, man. So, like I said, in a sense, he is right. But, like, if we being honest, Nunu, if you want people to stop attacking you, if you want people to stop making you out to be a battle rap thot, you better give some clarity. I don't give a fuck what you surf say. You better give some clarity. Like you better be direct. Like, no more looking guilty. No more laughing it off. No more indirectly saying, you didn't do it. Like, fuck all that. And I get it. It's cool. Like, it's fucking, it's safe. It's, you know, it makes sense for her to lean towards what Sue Surf said. Like, not explaining it, because when he said that, she agreed. She agreed to it. She was like, yeah, I ain't got to explain myself. You just gave her an escape route. Like, now that's her scapegoat. Like, I don't got to explain. And women always carry it like that. Like, that's not, nah, bro. As men, nah, I can't respect you giving her that kind of advice as a man, bro. Like, And I'm not contradicting myself with being hypocritical. I still stand with what I said. Like, you feel me? I still agree with you. Like, in a sense, it's not our business, so it really don't matter. She don't owe us an explanation. She's not obligated to tell us anything. But if she want niggas to stop attacking her, bro, she's going to have to give some clarity, bro. She's going to have to be direct. She's going to have to come out and be like, listen, I fuck Beasley, nigga. Fuck you niggas. It's my pussy. Fuck all you niggas, nigga. I don't give a fuck. Fuck you mean? Like, she gonna have to wear that shit. You feel me? Or just be like, I didn't fuck her. My ex-husband was tripping. You feel me? Now, niggas is still gonna say what they say. Niggas still gonna make that memes. Niggas still gonna joke. But I'm gonna tell you something, bro. People respect honesty, bro. And it's not just in battle rap. It's in any facet of life, bro. Any walk of life. Like, people respect honesty. If you fuck up at work, bro, and let's say you stole a box of trash bags. Let's just say you stole a box of trash bags and you get caught. Like you never know, bro. Your store manager, like your boss, might allow you to like he might allow you to continue your employment, bro. He might keep you if you be honest. If you just admit, like, yeah, I fucked up, I stole it. You ain't even gotta give him an explanation. Just admit your wrongs. Like, yeah, yo, I fucked up, I stole it, I apologize. You might be able to keep your job. Or you might get terminated, but I guarantee you, if your boss a real nigga or a real female, they're going to respect your honesty. You feel me? Man, you know how many times I heard the police tell me, like, say some shit like, but like, I'm going to ask you this question. If you be honest with me, I can work with you. You feel me? Like, but if you lie, you're going to make it worse for yourself. Like, so, I'm not saying anything about alluding to, like, you snitch or I snitch. No, I'm just saying, like, people respect honesty. So if you did what you did, and you just come out and wear it. No, like, when the public see that a person, bro, an individual, male, female, is not embarrassed by something, they tend to usually leave it alone. If a motherfucker is keep calling you black African booty scratcher, you dark ass nigga, we only see your teeth in the dark, like, just make jokes of you, and you're like, so? Gives a fuck. Yeah, I'm black. Still get bitches or whatever. Like, you wear that shit, niggas gonna stop joking about it because it's not affecting you. It's not bothering you. People only keep that stuff in and fuck with you when they see you bothered by it. If you're not bothered by it, they're going to fucking cease fire. So if you want people to cease fire and stop attacking you and calling you a thot and making these memes, I know you're trying to laugh it off, but you're a female. Deep down inside, you are bothered. You probably be crying every morning. You feel me? You probably, man, I know you cussed your husband out. Listen, you can smile all you want. I know you cussed that nigga out. I know you threatened him. I know you probably told that nigga he never gonna see his daughter again. You's a female. So she acting like it ain't bothering her, but it is, bro. And this is my advice. Just give some clarity, whether you did or you didn't. Just give niggas something to stand on, bro. If not, you can't get mad because now it's open for interpretation. People, it's room to assume because they didn't get a clear cut answer. So, sir, stop what you're doing, bro. Stop what you're doing, bro. You like, sometimes you be on some red pill shit. Sometimes you be on some blue pill shit, bro. Stop what you're doing. You mad enough.